So my name is Ruth, and I'm a biomedical scientist. And a biomedical scientist is a scientist that works in a laboratory in a hospital in order to help the doctors find out what's wrong with the patients. So when somebody's ill and they end up in hospital or they go to the doctors, then specimens are often taken from that patient to determine what's wrong with that patient. So those specimens go to the laboratory, which is where the biomedical scientists are trying to find out. They do tests on those specimens and we try and find out what's wrong with the patient. And then we pass that information back to the doctor and then they can work out a plan to get those patients back better again. Awesome. So that's my role. And there's different departments within pathology. So pathology is the name of the department in the hospital where the biomedical scientists work. And there's different departments within there. There's hematology, that's a department where the blood samples would go to. You've got microbiology, which is where I'm from, where we try and investigate, well, we do investigate what might be infecting the person, so what microorganisms infecting the patient. You've got biochemistry as well, and there's another department called histology. I did also work in histology, so I started in histology, and histology is a department where we analyse the cells from a patient's body. So that could be the kind of lumps and bumps that get taken off at surgery. They go to the laboratory to be investigated to find out exactly what that lump or bump is. So that's another department. So yeah, so I'm from microbiology, and we grow up the viruses and the bacteria and the fungi and all those horrible things that might be infecting the patient to let the doctors know what it is.
Awesome. What do you think is required to get into this career field in terms of personal qualities as an individual?
Well, you have to have an interest in science, of course. And I think for me, well, for anyone working in the laboratory, you have to be really well organised and to be able to follow procedures. So you can't just do what you think is right for something. You know, you've got to follow the procedures that are set out by the laboratory staff and the management. And if everybody is following the right procedure and doing it all the same, then that's obviously going to be a lot better for the department because we're all working together doing the same thing. So being methodical, following instructions, and having an interest in science, they're all really important.
What sort of qualifications do you need to get involved?
Well, it depends on what level you want to be at. So we have medical lab assistants who've got GCSE. Some of them may have A levels. Some of them may actually even got degrees, but maybe they got the degree in the wrong kind of subject. So it depends on what level you want. So if you're an entry level medical lab assistant, then you don't need many qualifications at all. You just need to have the aptitude to work in the laboratory and follow procedures and enjoy the science and work in your team. But if you want to be a qualified biomedical scientist, then you have to have an accredited degree in the biomedical science. So you have to follow the correct qualification to get into the job. So that depends where you want to go. I suppose, well, many of the MLAs who come in, entry level, come into the laboratory, they can then start learning and studying the right qualification to become a biomedical scientist. So we can grow in-house the scientists that come in as medical lab assistants. So we can grow them up and train them up to be biomedical scientists. So it depends, you know, you can either go out and find the accredited biomedical science degree and study that and then apply for a job, or you can come in at a lower grade and then work your way up that way. That's only if they have a vacancy for biomedical science for you. Not necessarily will they have a job available if you come in as a medical lab assistant. Yeah, so I have to have a think about that. So you might be a medical lab assistant for quite a long time before you get to be a biomedical scientist. But if you know that's a job you really want to do, then getting the right qualification to start with is really important, I'd say.
Okay. What do you find most interesting about microbiology, or what do you enjoy the most?
I like most doing the actual work. So I've got some specimens here I want to show you. So actually growing the bacteria onto agar plates. So what I'm showing you now is a Petri dish, which has got some agar in it. And agar is the food that bacteria love to eat. It's got lots of nutrients in the agar. And on my agar plate here, I've got lots of different colourful colonies. So I've got pink ones, purple ones, green ones, white ones. And I absolutely love this part of the work, actually preparing this Petri dish from the patient's specimen. Here I have growing the bacteria that were infecting them. And they come out in lots of lovely different colours. And actually, the smell as well. I know you can't smell this, Miles, because you're on the other end of the computer. But these have a smell to them. You see them and you can touch them as well. So I love the practical side of things, of doing, you know, the actual preparing specimens and growing the bacteria and finding out what's wrong with the patient. That's the best bit. Definitely.
What sort of advice would you give to a young person that's interested in getting involved in your field?
If they're interested in microbiology, then I would recommend definitely find a microbiology laboratory near to you. So microbiology doesn't just happen in the pathology lab in the hospital. It could be research. It could be a pharmaceutical company. We've got a, not far from where I am, there's a cosmetic company. They make cosmetics, but they have a microbiology lab there because they have to make sure that all the ingredients coming in to the department are pure and they're not contaminated. So everything gets checked before they make the cosmetics with it. So try and investigate where there's microbiology happening in your area and then get in touch. Get in touch with them, pick up the phone and speak to somebody and see if you can get in there and do some work experience or have a look around or have a chat with somebody about the role that of a microbiologist in their department.
Cool. Right. Brilliant. Thank you so much, Ruth. Really, really, really interesting. And yeah, hopefully to anyone watching and listening, that has been really informative and we hope this helps you a lot. Thank you. Thanks.
Thank you so much. Bye.